Well, an unprecedented crisis posed an unprecedented problem before the Indian judiciary. The question they were confronted with is, can the Indian courts go into an indefinite lockdown, or can there be an alternative where the justice delivery system continues subject to safeguards? In such a scenario, online hearings was a natural solution.
And when they did go online, allowing lawyers as well as judges to make their representations, make their arguments, even pass orders and directions over the course of an online hearing, and all of this happening first with the Supreme Court, later across various high courts, using multiple platforms such as video, such as Cisco WebEx. In fact, in some cases, they even made their representations via WhatsApp.
Well, so how exactly does an online hearing work? This is a very good example of an online hearing taking place. It's the Supreme Court. They're using the video app. That's the Chief Justice himself. There are a number of boxes. They've joined from their residences or their chambers. That's the Chief Justice, flanked by Justice Lalit, Justice Chandrachur. In the smaller boxes, if you pay attention, that's the Solicitor General. The Attorney General has also joined this hearing from his residence, as well as Senior Advocate Vikas Singh. So in principle, it is a sound idea. It was welcomed by many stakeholders, but it's not without its fair share of problems.
We are more tense about the technical aspects of things, about being able to log in into a video conference and to say our stuff before something goes wrong in terms of either the internet going off or the electricity going off. And it can happen at various ends. It can happen at the end of the council. It can happen at the end of the court. So the thing is that nobody is very comfortable with it, but there is no other alternative.
Now, while there are a number of these technical glitches, the bigger problem, the bigger concern that lawyers point out is one of livelihood. They argue that the high courts, as well as the top court of the country, are hearing a fraction of the cases they normally do, only urgent, important matters, which essentially means fewer cases for lawyers to argue.
The detrimental effect that it has had on the legal community, the professionals, and many of them have been forced to take up other jobs. Many of them have been forced to rely on donations and financial support. A lot of privileged lawyers have come forward to support and help. Several bar council, bar associations are doing their bit to help out. But of course, this is not in the long run sustainable.
There is also a concentration of work in the hands of the better known lawyers. So what happens is that, supposing it's a high profile urgent hearing, a litigation which is either corporate or political in nature, you know who the lawyers, who the senior counsels would be on either side.
Well, that's not the only concern. In fact, on a lighter note, the lawyers point out that with them munching more megabytes than miles, there's a definite impact on health as well.
In your regular day on a Supreme Court, you have seen lawyers running across the length and breadth of corridors, managing to reach their cases, and it gives them sufficient. On a regular day, on Mondays to Fridays, I used to clock at least 4,500 to 5,000 steps, which has gone down now to maximum 1,000 to 1,500.
But what about the way forward? We ask if online hearings are here to stay.
I could attend on a normal scenario. I would not be able to rush from NCLT to High Court to Supreme Court and Patiala House back. But I managed to attend all four hearings and got matters, it moved forward. Some of them got disposed of for the simple reason that it was all at the click of the button and I didn't have to physically move out.
All of us have to up our game. I was speaking to a tech-savvy judge of a high court who says that he now pays attention to three screens at the same time in a court hearing. One screen is in which he interacts with the lawyers. On another screen, he is looking at all the documents and the pleadings in the case. And on a third screen, he's making his personal notes. Very few judges and lawyers have upped their game to that kind of capability.
Well, the jury may still be out on how effective these online hearings are, given the constraints and given the technical glitches. However, there is a near unanimous verdict among all stakeholders that this is a phenomena, online hearings, that will continue in the Indian judiciary far beyond than just the pandemic. In New Delhi, Ashmit Kumar.